Welcome everyone.
I am Peter. I work as a developer at SVI and I'm going to present you the latest features of Huygens Localizer, our solution for two-dimensional and three-dimensional single molecule localization microscopy. First, some practical information. We recommend watching this presentation full screen at a resolution of at least 720p. If you have a question, please submit it in the sidebar on the right. We will try to answer all questions as quickly as possible. In this presentation, I will present Huygens Localizer and its new 3D mode, which features robust calibration using the Huygens PSF distiller. I will give a demonstration of Huygens Localizer to show the analysis of 3D SMLM data. Finally, I will finish with some remarks on computation speed and on some additional features of Huygens Localizer. Here is an example of the type of data we are talking about. At the left, you see an accumulated image from a time series acquired by our collaborators at the EMBL using localization microscopy. This is the equivalent of a normal wide-field fluorescent microscopy image. It has lots of background and the resolution is too low to resolve the very fine features of the microtubules. On the right, you see the super-resolution reconstruction of this data by Huygens Localizer, which has a much higher resolution and does not suffer from the background. This approach is not limited to two-dimensional images. Now, with the latest version of Huygens Localizer, we can also analyze 3D SMLM data. So, how does single molecule localization microscopy work? Here is a figure from an upcoming paper about Huygens Localizer in Microscopy Today that summarizes the principles. Panel A shows a simple object consisting of two densely labeled lines that are spaced at a distance much less than the resolution of the microscope. If each fluorophore emits light, then the image looks like one big blur, as in panel B, due to the limited resolution of the microscope. We cannot resolve the two lines. However, if we could just see the light of, say, two fluorophores, as in panel C, then we see two big blobs of light, but we know that at each center of the blob there is a fluorophore. So if we do that repeatedly for all fluorophores, we can reconstruct a high-resolution image by plotting the exact fluorophore positions as shown in panel D. This is of course the principle of all modern localization microscopy techniques, such as PALM, STORM, DS-DIM or PAINT. By keeping in mind this basic principle, we can analyze data from all these systems in the same way. So, the principle of SMLM super-resolution is straightforward. Given a sequence of images of individual fluorophores, construct a table of the fluorophore localizations, and then render a super-resolved image using those localizations. This is in a nutshell what Huygens Localizer does for you in an efficient, user-friendly package. So far, we have talked about super-resolution by localizing fluorophores in two dimensions. This gives us two-dimensional images. What if we want to resolve structures in three dimensions? SMLM systems can be extended for 3D imaging by modifying the optics. For instance, if you insert a cylindrical lens in the detection part of the microscope, you get an astigmatic PSF. What this means is that an image of a single fluorophore changes its shape as a function of its position in the Z direction. If you look at the image of a fluorophore located at the focus of the microscope, it is more or less symmetric, as shown here. But if the fluorophore is located below or above the focus, you get an elliptically shaped spot with a width and height that depend on the position of your fluorophore. Given this point spread function as a stack of images, we can then calculate calibration curves of the width and the height as a function of Z, as shown to the right. Now, if you look at the images acquired by such a system, you will see that the single fluorophores have different ellipsoidal shapes depending on their axial position. So if we fit not only the position, but also the width and height of the spots, we can derive the Z position using the calibration curves and finally render a three-dimensional representation of the object at high resolution. Huygens Localizer is our all-in-one solution for two-dimensional and three-dimensional localization microscopy. It is designed to be easy to use and interactive and employs multiprocessing and GPU acceleration to make sure that you get your results as fast as possible. I will first give a bit more detail on how Huygens Localizer works before proceeding with a demonstration of the software. The Huygens Localizer workflow is as follows. Given an image series, first the static background is detected, since we're only interested in single fluorophores. These fluorophores are then detected and their location is fitted using one of the fitting algorithms that we support. This results in a table of fluorophores that can optionally be filtered to remove unwanted particles, and drift correction can also be applied to this point. I will go into more detail on this in the demo. And finally, the localizations can be rendered into a high resolution image. Note that each of these steps is implemented using efficient multicore CPU code and accelerated using GPU calculations. I will now continue with the demo of the Huygens Localizer using 3D SMLM images of the mitochondrial membrane protein TOM20 image using paint kindly provided to us by Marco Lamben of the EMBL. In particular, I will show you how to use the Huygens PSF distiller to obtain a PSF of the image system that can be used for calibration. Then I will use this calibration PSF with the Huygens Localizer Wizard to analyze 3D SMLM data. So, let's start the demo. This is the Huygens Localizer main window. I've already preloaded some data. This data is an SMLM data series, actually paint data of TOM20. An antibody against TOM20, which labels the mitochondrial membrane. So if we scroll to the frames of this data series, you can actually see that the images of the fluorophores have different shapes. They're wider or higher depending on the Z position. So this is 3D SMLM data, and we're going to analyze that with the 3D localizer. And for that, we first need some calibration data. So we need to derive the point smack function of the system. For that, I have loaded an image with tetra specs, beads of 100 nanometer diameter here. This is a Z stack, so images of this tetra specs as a function of the Z. And if we step to this Z stack, then we see near the focus the points are more or less symmetric, while they become higher or wider depending on the position relative to the focus. So we're going to use this to derive the point smack function, and for that we start in the analysis menu first the PSF distiller wizard. So we'll step to the wizard, and the first thing we'll see is that you can change the parameters of your image, which is not needed here because they have been loaded properly. So we continue, we set the bead diameter, 100 nanometers, we give an estimate of the signal-to-noise ratio, which we leave as it is fine. Then after a small warning about the actual size of the data, which is not so important for SMLM data, the wizard finds a number of beads. It finds actually two beads it can use. These are the green dots you see at the left. The other beads are not suitable because they're either too close to each other or too close to the edge of the window. Two beads is, however, enough, so we continue. And we start the distillation. The wizard finds then some instability in illumination, which it can correct, but we'll continue. And then finally, distillation is done, and we have a PSF as shown here at the right. So let's export that. And then we here can look at the PSF. And we see at the focus it is nearly symmetric, and if we go to the focus, it gets higher or wider. So this we can use for calibration. So now, let's look at the data with the Localizer 3D. Localizer 3D, shown here, on the left is the data again, which you can look at. In the middle is an empty table where our results will be shown, and to the right is an empty image where the visualization of the results will be shown. The bottom we have on the left a help area, in the middle an area analyzes reports, now empty, and to the right we have the interface for the parameters. I'll start by pressing the crop time series button, where we can see a plot of the intensity over time, and we'll use this to make the series a bit smaller, about half its original size, so that the analysis will be a bit faster. We then enter the wizard, and the first thing we're going to be asked is to check the parameters, such as the sampling of the data and the macro aperture of the lens and so on. And if necessary, change them, but we don't need to do that because these have been read correctly already. Then we are asked for some channel-dependent parameters, such as the wavelength, also correctly read, so we can continue. Then we are asked if we want to use background estimation. That's normally a good idea, so we leave it at the default, which is yes. And then we come to the particle identification stage. Here we see on the left top, we see that which particles have been found. These are marked by yellow circles. We can change the parameters here, which will also update the display of the particles that are found. For instance, if we change the slider, which is a relative threshold, we are going to find less or more particles. But actually, I'm going to leave also this value at its default of 1.5, because usually that is actually correct, and for this data it works fine. Then in the next stage, we can select the algorithm we want to use, maximum likelihood, or least squares, or weighted least squares. We'll stick to least squares, which is fast and reliable. We can also set an estimate for the size of the PSF, but that's automatically determined already, so we didn't need to change that either. So we continue. Now we come at the point where we have to load our calibration data. So here I import the PSF, and then the program creates two curves, which are the width and the height of the PSF as a function of the Z position. Now these curves are a bit bent and strange at the edges, but this is because they are over a range of about 4 micrometer, while normally you can only really use the middle range of 1 micrometer, where this type of analysis with astigmatic lenses is reliable. So we're going to only use the 1 micrometer in the middle of these curves, which is fine. Let's continue to the last stage, where we start the analysis. Here we press first the optimize button. What it does is it calculates the optimal number of frames it can calculate simultaneously on the GPU. The more you can put on your GPU, the faster it is. But that depends, of course, on the type of GPU you have. So you have to optimize that, and this button does that. Let's start the analysis. We get some output in the bottom, and then after the first set of frames that we analyze, we get results in the table here, and then the first visualization to the right. So what happens in the visualization is that at each location we see here in the table, a small dot with a Gaussian shape is put in the image, and these are added up to form a final super resolution image. Well, this is a pretty big series. We're actually more or less done now. Yes, that's it. And we can inspect the result. So this is a 3D data set, so we also have a 3D visualization. If we scroll to the Z slices, we see indeed that we can resolve the 3-dimensional structure of the mitochondria. And we see that it actually labels the membrane of the mitochondria as expected. I still don't find the result optimal. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change a parameter here in the rendering. I'm going to change the size of the little dot we use to represent each flue for, make it a bit smaller, so we get a bit sharper image. Now let's focus on this structure here. This seems to be kind of a hollow spherical structure, but it still looks pretty blurred here, and this is most likely because there was drift during the acquisition. So I'm pressing the drift corrector button here. It starts the drift corrector. which is also working on the GPU, so this also is pretty fast. And if you wait a little bit more, we'll see the result in the form of a plot of the drifts that have been found, like here. And then we see indeed that there was not much drift in the X direction, the red line, but there is almost 250 nanometer drift in the Y direction. And that is a lot on the scale we are looking. And indeed, if you switch between no drift correction and drift correction, we can see that after drift correction, the result is much better defined and much sharper. We can also see that here for the whole image very nicely. No drift correction with drift correction. So now we have the result. We can inspect that. And we see very clearly the nice labeling of the mitochondrial membrane. So this is a Z-stack which we inspect by going to the slices. We also have a table where we can inspect the individual localizations if we like. But we can also render the results in three dimensions using, for instance, the MIP renderer. It renders a three-dimensional representation of the data, which we can rotate so that we can look at any angle we like at the result. This is finalizes the analysis, so I press done, and the results are exported as a table here and as the rendered image. So the rendered image we can look at again, and we can save it, of course. You can also again visualize it, for instance, with a MIP renderer. The table we can, if we like, open with a localization viewer, which allows us to render it again with different parameters. And of course, we can also save the table, for instance, as a comma separated value table. So this concludes the demonstration. Let's finish the presentation with a few final points. First of all, Huygens Localizer is designed to be very fast because you do not want to spend 1 hour to calculate your super resolution image. Huygens Localizer uses highly optimized parallel code, so even on an average desktop computer it's quite fast, as shown here in comparison to the widely used package Thunderstorm. If you bring GPU acceleration into the mix, it gets even better. Using a mid-range GPU on a standard desktop computer, we can get more than 10 times as fast. So if you needed an hour to analyze your data before, you will be done in about 5 minutes now. Finally, if you go for high-end hardware, you can easily get more than a factor of 30 acceleration. I want to quickly mention two important additional features. The first is the batch processor, which allows you to quickly analyze many large datasets automatically. Furthermore, Huygens Localizer includes the Object Analyzer module, which lets you make quantitative measurements in your super-resolved images. To summarize, Huygens Localizer is our easy-to-use interactive solution for processing 2D and 3D localization microscopy data. It features a step-by-step GUI with extensive help. It offers interactive pre- and post-processing tools to get the most out of your data. And finally, but quite important, it supports many file formats to load your data. In particular, all major microscopy vendor formats are supported. So Huygens Localizer is a fast, fully featured package for both 2D and 3D localization. In this presentation, I focused on the 3D features of Huygens Localizer. By including the Huygens PSF distiller, you can reliably measure high-quality point spread functions of your system, and this leads to a very robust calibration of 3D SMLM data. Huygens Localizer offers drift correction, that can be very important, as we saw in the demonstration. Finally, several modules are included for visualization, quantitative analysis, and batch processing. This brings me to the end of the presentation. Thank you for watching. Do not hesitate to submit your questions directly in the sidebar or email us at support@svi.nl. Finally, I thank our collaborators for discussion and data, Nancy, Gert, Johan, Marco, and Mikko. If you want to know more about Hagen Localizer, check it out on our website or get some more details in our white paper that you can download from the site. If you would like to give Hagen Localizer a try, download it from our website. You can request a free test license to activate the software. I hope you enjoyed our presentation on Hagen Localizer. Thank you for watching and goodbye.